Jazz funk pioneer Herbie Hancock was on a roll during the first half of the 70s, turning out one landmark release after another. And the final release of his Headhunters period, Manchild, might just be the best, largely on the strength of the slow groove atmospheric numbers, Sun Touch and Bubbles. And the second of those I am going to play right now, being perhaps my favorite Hancock number of all, from his 1975 release, Manchild, Bubbles. I'm hearing very slow, not the characteristics of wah-wah that people recognize, but what you can get with that pedal when it's just kind of open. The bass is creating just this smooth bed, while the guitar is just being very faint, putting in choice notes. Just keep throwing in these sustained notes. They'll either be like faint, like in one channel, or they'll be like thick and kind of right in the center. I was just wondering that I don't quite know for sure where that tingling, that like spine tingling sound is coming from. Is that Wawa Watson doing some strange technique on his guitar, or is that Herbie? Right there. Foundation of this track was like, what came first? Was it the bass line? Because like the chordal centers are very simple. It's the atmosphere that's created out of them, though, that gives everything this like lush beauty. They throw in like a sinister note, like right here we're in B. No, we were in B B-flat, but they threw in some strange note that's quite odd for that key center. I'm thinking that's a guitar, but that is a very unique little figure right there. Hear those shimmery sounds, those shimmery sustains, they're just coming out of nowhere. They're like fading in intensity, and then they just like fade out. A bit of clavinet right there, very faint though. Not the typical like scratchy clavinet, just very subtle. I should read off the credits as well. I'll read off what Herbie is playing. According to Discogs, he's playing acoustic piano, electric, not necessarily on this track, electric piano, Fender Rhodes, heard some of that. Let's see, synthesizer. He plays Arp Odyssey, Pro Soloist, 2600, string ensemble, Oberheim Polyphonic, and a Hohner D6 clavinet. And some of you who are more versed in the different makes and models can probably pick each one of these out. I'm going to have to be a little bit more basic in my assumptions. Like clavinet versus synth versus electric piano for the most part. Like wheezing sound coming out of this speaker. Well, maybe you can't tell, but like it's that high-pitched thing that's coming out. What is it that's making that bass line so velvety? Line is coming in here. Or it was, but this is starting to get a little bit more dense. We've got quite a few things going on. It seems like Herbie's doing several things at once now. Either Wayne Shorter or Maupin. Yeah. Benny Maupin. Parts are just so choicely are just placed in such a selective yet effective way. That now the bass line that we've been hearing this whole time, I guess, is courtesy of the very ubiquitous Paul Jackson. Like those like rising shimmery or like kind of like luminous keyboards that are coming out, they have like the effect of like steam. And then or it's like that saxophone is like steam, and the synthesizers are like fog. Moisture. Steam. I must say that the overall feel, the overall ambience of this track really matches the red, the thick red cover art quite well. That really hot, like molten coastal. It's like a prehistoric coastline, like back when the earth was really, let's just say, uninhabitable to humans. Songs that I would be happy. I've allowed that song to just play on repeat for upwards of an hour at times. It's just I've taken naps to that song. It's beautiful. What can I say? It's a perfect song. It's very much a sunset number. Herbie Hancock, the track Bubbles, off his 1975 release Manchild. The last of his releases with the Headhunters. There were a few renditions of this number. I believe there may have been another one that same year off of his... No. I'm mistaken. Seeking for a minute. There may have been one on Flood, no. I'm pretty sure he's recorded this elsewhere, though, at some point. There was another track named Bubbles, another very beautiful, kind of quiet, stormy instrumental that was not like this, but similar in feel. It was written by Shunzu Ono and appeared on his 1976 album, Japanese Jazz Guy. And then it was that one was covered by Norman Connors on his 1976 You Are My Starship. And the point really, I guess, behind that being that Bubbles is just a very evocative title for instrumentals of this nature, that really warm, velvety, like, just, you know, that environment like that. Kind of like, as if you're in a jacuzzi or something, or a jacuzzi at the coast, you know, watching the sun go down. And there were quite a lot of play. Unfortunately, neither Discogs nor Wiki breaks down who plays what on each song. So of this long list of credits, I mean, on the Manchild album, aside from Herbie on all those keyboards that I listed, we have credits being... We have Wawa Watson on guitar. He's also credited on synthesizer. We've got Paul Jackson being the most recognizable bassist, but we've also got Louise Johnson and Henry Davis on bass. Mike Clark, James Gadson, Harvey Mason, all credited on drums. Bill Summers on percussion. Once again, I don't know how many of these appeared on Bubbles per se. Bill Summers did a pretty good jazz funk album a couple of years later. Stevie Wonder even appeared somewhere on the album playing a harmonica. Garnet Brown, trombone, Wayne Shorter, alto and soprano saxophones, Benny Malpin, soprano and tenor saxophone, bass clarinet, alto and bass flute, sax solo, percussion. I guess it's a safer bet to assume that Benny Malpin was the one heard on this number, since he was in the... As a matter of fact, it's a safe bet to assume that the people that we did hear, aside from Herbie Hancock, are bassist Paul Jackson, percussionist Bill Summers, drummer Harvey Mason, saxist Benny Malpin, and drummer Mike Clark, the Headhunters. Oh, wait a minute. Maybe not as much Harvey Mason, because he was replaced by Mike Clark at some point during the recording of this album. Yeah. And there you have it. The clocking in at nine minutes and 3 seconds. It's the second longest track on the album. And for more Rubies and Sapphires from Manchild and many other, upwards of about 10 or 12 Herbie Hancock albums from his electric period, see the directory of albums by American jazz funk artists listed in the links below, and like and subscribe and follow me on Facebook and Twitter. And until next time, this is Aragon, the world's most air travel tri-maximalist, signing off.